connecting one of these split stovepipes together can be a challenge.
The difficulty is getting this slot into this channel. The pipe in its round shape doesn't allow it to just match right up. Instead, you have to push it down and get it in place. It's not recommended to take a screwdriver and try and open up this channel.
I'm going to have to push this pipe down into an oval shape in order to get this slot to go into this channel. Doing this on the workbench is probably going to be too hard, so I'm going to go to the floor. I've put some paper down to protect the pipe, and after you've worked with the pipe for a little bit, it's going to be in this oval shape. And now I can get these to meet each other. But I'm going to start at the back end so I can use my legs to hold the joint in place as I work my way up the pipe. Putting that slot in, I'm going to put my knees on either side of it. And the challenge is you need to hold down constant pressure as you work your way up, and you will not succeed the first time. Working my way up some more. I'm pushing down the whole time, getting that joint in there. Putting my knees up. I'm compressing my knees together to hold this pipe together, and I'm pushing down on this joint to get this slot to go into the channel. And there we go. You heard the snap, this one's done. Now the next step is to rotate it and push it down back into a round shape. And I do this a little bit at a time. To get the pipe to a round-ish shape. I think this one's round enough, good enough. I'm gonna get started on this next one. Before going to the floor, one thing you can do is start shaping it how you want it to, you wanna give it some flexibility. I'm gonna go ahead and open it up a little bit. I'm just working from one end to the next. I don't wanna stress anything too much. And then for each side, curl it down just a little bit to give us a little bit of a favorable angle. And I don't want to put a crease along the back side. Do the same thing on this side here. Just a little bit of an angle. Keep in mind how much angle you put in here, you're going to have to bend out to make it round again. So it's a balance between making it easy to snap together or bending it back in shape. Choose your battle. I think this is good enough pre-bending. I'm gonna go down to the floor now. You should know each pipe has its own personality. Sometimes they fight you, sometimes they're a little bit more cooperative. I'm gonna check to see if I could just get this in here okay. And it looks like this is gonna be a real hard one here. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna take that apart. You see how much I've bent it down. I think I'm gonna need to bend this down a lot more to get it in a more favorable shape to put together. So let's start. Now try putting that slot in again. Ooh. Just getting it started sometimes. Ooh, wiggle, wiggle. Okay. So it's in there just barely. Let's get started. Put my knees on either side of the pipe. Push down. Working that slot into that channel. Okay, that's attempt one. probably one of five. Starting again. And I'm pushing down on this thing pretty hard. Get it in place. Well, it's really fighting me here. I just put a crease in the pipe right there. I pushed too hard. That's not good. Go in. Oh, it's so close. It's like a millimeter away. It's in up to about this point. So right here, it's starting to... Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, yeah, just a little persuasion. Okay. So I heard it snap into place, but I think it's still... If I turn it over and start forming it into a circle, we're probably going to hear this joint snap again. Let's see. There we go. That's what we want to hear. That's the sound of victory. Woo! Got away from me there. That's looking pretty round. That's pretty round. Yeah. That side. Oh, that's pretty oval. I could have put more pressure on that while I was on the ground. Okay. I'm going to call that victory. With this third pipe, I put a little too much pressure in one spot and made a tiny indent. Be careful with how aggressive you are with your pipe wrestling. With my three pipes now formed, I'm going to finish installing the stack for the stove and get some heat in this workshop.